President Kolinda Grabar-Kitarović will be receiving this afternoon leaders of parliamentary parties for consultations on the giving of a mandate for the forming of a government. In line with the constitution, the president is the one to decide on the person given the mandate to form the government based on the consultations and evidence of support of most MPs. Negotiations between the Most Alliance members and the SDP and HDZ-led coalitions continue today. Once a new round of negotiations was completed this morning with the SDP, most representatives crossed over to the HDZ headquarters for a new round of talks with that coalition. The talks were said to focus, among others, on most's demands for an exclusive economic zone to be declared in the Adriatic. Former Prime Minister Ivo Sanader is spending his first day out of jail in more than 3 years following a decision by the Zagreb County Court based on a constitutional court ruling which said that Sanader's investigative custody was extended illegally. The USKOK anti-corruption agency has announced it would contest the ruling. Sanader has meanwhile said he was no longer interested in politics and would concentrate on his defense in the embezzlement cases against him. At its session on Thursday morning, the government cabinet allocated an additional 3 million kuna from budgetary reserves for expenses related to caring for migrants. Since the start of the migrant crisis in Croatia in mid-September, some 444,000 migrants and refugees passed through the country. However, currently the Slavonski Brod winter camp is all but deserted. Meanwhile, the Interior Minister Ranko Ostojic is in Greece, where he'll be meeting with the Greek Migrations Minister. Ostojic will also be paying a visit to a crew of a Croatian police vessel involved in assisting the migrant crisis. The Croatian Homeland War Memorial Documentation Center is marking its 10th anniversary and the beginning of scientific research work. It specializes in collecting, sorting, and researching documents from the Homeland War. So far, it has published or co-published some 62 books. Take a quick look at sports. In Champions League handball, PPD Zagreb plays host to Turkish side Beşiktaş tonight at 7 p.m. Meanwhile, in EuroLeague basketball action, Cedevita is in France tonight, where they face Limoges at 8:30 p.m. And the weather. Cloud to continue in the afternoon with light precipitation in the southern Adriatic and sections of central Adriatic, which will turn to snow at high elevations and sleet in eastern Slavonia. Strong and gale force Bora will bring about problems in traffic along the Adriatic motorway and motorways close to the seaside, as well as fast ferry and ferry services. This will be initially true for the northern Adriatic and will later spread to the south. See mostly moderate to choppy, very choppy in the open. Inland temperatures between 0 and 4 degrees, somewhat lower at high elevations, and between 7 and 12 degrees along the coast. It will continue to be colder than average for November in the coming days, but daily temperatures will increase considerably as of Sunday and it will most probably be dry. However, on Friday and Saturday, there still might be some sleet in places and snow at high elevations. Friday will remain blustery, particularly along the coast. Bora to weaken further on Saturday and there will still be a little rain in the south. More sun and warmth expected as of Sunday.